Hello, you're watching Proactive London. Joining me today is Martin Horgan. He's the Chief Executive of Centamin. Martin, it's good to speak with you today.
Good morning, and thanks for having me. How are you today?
Very well, thank you. So, Martin, we haven't interviewed you before on Proactive. So for those viewers not familiar with the company, can you tell us more about Centamin?
Sure, delighted to. Well, we're a FTSE-listed company. Our prime asset, or primary asset, is the Sukari mine, which is in the eastern desert of Egypt. Been in production for about 10 years now, and I think we categorise that as a tier one asset at this stage. It is produces currently about 450,000 ounces, but targeting get up to 500,000 ounces of gold per year from a combined open pit and underground operation. Standard CIL processing in this facility. So, a pretty large scale operation with a 10 year track record, another sort of 12 years plus ahead of us in terms of mine life as well. So a really sort of exciting asset. That sits within a strategic land holding that we've recently acquired within Egypt, one of the emerging sort of exploration jurisdictions with a recent change in the law. And we've got a 3,000 square kilometer package of ground there for further discovery. And then pivoting across to West Africa, we've got a portfolio of pretty exciting exploration and development assets over there, focused primarily on Côte d'Ivoire. We have the Doropo project, which sits to the north of Côte d'Ivoire, where we're completing a pre-feasibility study. And then we've got a pretty exciting exploration project at the ABC project over on the west border of Côte d'Ivoire as well. So a producer with an integrated exploration and development pipeline listed here in London. Final thing to say is that in a very, very sort of good position, we've got no debt, no hedging in the business. And currently we've got about $256 million of cash and liquids as well. That's Centamin in a snapshot.
It's been nearly 2 years since you joined Centamin. In that time, we've seen a significant turnaround for the company. What's been the main driver behind this, Martin?
I think early on in the piece, back in, as I joined in 2020, and the sort of the message and the mantra that we delivered since then is all about people. I mean, this really is a people business. And we talked about sort of the right people and the right processes. And that's been a real focus over the last, well, certainly the first 8 to 12 months I was on board. And I think over the last 12 months that we've seen now, the delivery of that focus effectively. So in terms of the leadership, we looked to sort of augment an already pretty good team. We're very happy with what we found, but felt that we just had to add a few more people in there just to round out the sort of the complementary skill set. A big focus on geology, the real bedrock of the business as we go for the real foundation for us, and we look to sort of split out both the exploration but importantly the ore body management role. We've added to our ESG capacity a clear focus now for all for ourselves, all our stakeholders, both in country and from an investor perspective as well. So I think we've added there, and then just a few smaller areas as well, but they're the kind of the key drivers. I think then the other thing is trusting in the process, is to really make sure that when we undertake the work that we do to basically plan and deliver the operations, is that we're looking at working to international best practice as best we can. And I think then really looking at the asset, certainly from a long-term basis, and seeing how that drives both medium and then short-term plans as well. And I think that's also been a really important part of a change in emphasis, if you like, about how we look at our operations. And when you have an asset of the scale and quality of Sukari, it is that really to make sure you maximize the value of it. It's about taking that longer term horizon and getting that to drive those short term plans as well. That led us to a series of conclusions about how to take the business forward. And we identified an investment period now that will build on the success of the last 10 years, build on the strength that we have in the company and the balance sheet, and then look to set us up for the next 10 years and beyond. And that's led to a range of initiatives at Sukari Mine. As I say, the mentioning the pickup of this exploration ground in Egypt, and then some real decision to take the West African portfolio, which had been exploration focused, and to put that on a development footing as well. So I think that investment profile that we see now going into the business is that it's really going to start to pay dividends and pay back for itself in the next 2 to 3 years for the long term as well. And I think then the final thing is to really focus on delivery. I think, be fair to say that Centamin over the last part of the last decade had sort of had a couple of missteps. And I think that had led to some potential investor sort of lack of confidence in the company. And I think one of the things that we really focused in 21 and we hope to keep continuing to 22 and beyond, is the fact that we're going to set some goals, ambitious targets for the business, and then really make sure that we deliver into them and tell people that we've delivered into them as well. And I think that was a really satisfying part of last year when we were able to meet our guidance both on cost and production. And I think that was the first time we've done that in 3 years as well. So I think, you know, there's no real sort of secret to this. It's about a focus on good practice and good principles, using, you know, the best people that we can find, working in the right way, and then making sure we deliver into our commitments and taking it back to basics, really.
You've just come back from site. How is Sukari set for 2022, Martin?
It was good. I had a really good trip, actually. Very much enjoyed that. And again, great to see the team on site. We've got a new GM in place. He started late last year, so I had a good chance to sort of have some time with him. And he's had a couple of swings at site now and really start to get some feeling about where he'd like to take the asset, what opportunity he sees, and where we can strengthen as well. So I think it was excellent to see him and that new leadership team there really starting to get excited about what we can see as well. Spent some really good time with the geology team. Last year, we announced a big uplift in both the resource and the reserve base of the mine. I think it's the biggest single annual increase we've done in the 10 years of production history. And despite delivering a 200% increase on the underground reserves, adding 1 million ounces to the total reserve base of the mine, is that the team are excited about what more they can do. We still see that there's lots more potential to be delivered at Sukari as well. So spending a good time with the GOs, working through what the plans are for this year, where they see it going. And we've set some pretty ambitious targets for further growth as well. So really understanding that was excellent for us. In terms of the operations themselves, the open pit continues to go well. Our team moved a record number of tons last year, and the pressure's on for them to repeat this year. And we have one of our main contractors, Capital Group. They've ramped up and are doing very nicely as well with a key project there. So that's moving along. I think the other big key for us this year is cost. You know, inflation clearly is a key theme now across the sector. And for us, as part of sort of continuous improvement culture that we're putting into the business, is that, you know, we're always looking at where we can improve our cost base. Production, one side of the coin, of course, we've got to produce as much gold as we can consistently, but also make sure that we generate that cash flow by cost initiatives as well. And we think there's still a good bit of opportunity of cost savings to come out of the business as we move forward. And one of the things that was really exciting to see was that we committed to a solar project last year, thinking about cost saving, thinking about our greenhouse gas targets. Within that investor piece I talked before around ESG, and we've decided to build a 36 megawatt solar plant. It's about a $30-odd million capex investment that'll come on stream middle of this year, and it was great to actually see the tangible progress of that solar project now, with actual panels being put in place as well. So really exciting to see that initiative coming through. And I finally got to play football with the team as well down there, so it was an honourable 4-4 draw. I think they were kind of being gentle on the old man as the CEO. I think I got a bit of leeway as well, but no, very good to see the team and get on the pitch as well.
Well, I see you have a football jumper behind you on the wall there, Martin. what can shareholders look forward to in the near future, apart from football updates?
Well, my team's Manchester United, so I won't be saying too much about those at the moment, to be honest with you. Look, I think that consistency, again, that we touched on earlier, that delivery into our stated goals, I think making sure that we continue now to continue to meet our guidance, that operational consistency in the short, the medium, the long term. I think that sort of, you know, the cost initiatives that I outlined earlier, continuing to sort of not only sort of look to stay on top of inflation, but actually beat it with the initiatives that we have. I think that, as I say, the solar plant coming on, I think that's hugely exciting to see that coming through as well. I think we've got quite a bit of upside still in the ore body to see the geology coming through on the main ore body for growth, the ability to expand the underground operations off the confidence we're having that underground expansion. So I think there's a lot more to come from Sukari itself. I think more broadly, the exploration bid round in that we have, that 3,000 square Ks in Egypt, we will start working on that now in this next quarter. I'm delighted we've been able to do that work, and we're all hugely excited about the potential of Egypt and the ability to get a large land package and explore it using modern techniques, which hasn't been done before as well. And of course, they continue to push on in West Africa, deliver that pre-feasibility for Doropo, and look forward to being able to give the results from that as well. I think, you know, that, if you like, is what we're looking at in terms of some of the short-term catalysts. And of course, that remains aligned to our sort of consistent sort of stakeholder return policy of ensuring around dividends as well as we go forward as well. So I think a lot achieved over the last 12, 18 months. I think, you know, the team have done fantastically despite the headwinds of COVID and the challenges that they've astonished me with their ability to do that. A record year in terms of our safety stats as well. So to be able to deliver that in those headwinds. And really, for me, the excitement is that the team isn't resting on its laurels. It's taking a real sort of sense of enthusiasm from last year's success and looking to build on that as we go forward as well. So I think well delivered from the team and a lot more to come as well.
Well, sounds like a positive story. And thank you very much for the update today, Martin.
Thank you very much for your time.
That's Martin Horgan. He's the chief executive of Centamin.